Can you really be led by the Holy Spirit every day of your life? This is session 6, where you will learn how to be guided by God's Spirit within you. Welcome back to session 6, where we cover how to partner with the Holy Spirit in being led by the inward witness within you. This session is designed to help you partner up and team up with God and team up with the Holy Spirit and be led by God's Spirit within you on a moment-by-moment basis throughout your daily life. I want to encourage you that as you do this, you will be able to lead God's best for your life. The Holy Spirit is God's Spirit. God is three persons: God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. He is the active agent on this earth that inhabits the believer in Jesus Christ. That's important to understand, that God inhabits you. Christianity is not a religion. It's a spiritual belief system where the God that you serve, the God of the universe, comes and actually inhabits and lives inside of you. Why is that important? Because as he lives inside of you, as you intentionally and become aware of his presence within you and live God inside minded, and you follow the prompting of the Holy Spirit, the inward witness, then you're able to be guided by God's Spirit on a moment-by-moment basis throughout your day. That is God speaking to you. Living God inside minded is so important. We've talked about that before. When you realize God inhabits you, when you realize that he speaks to you, and you become more aware of his presence within you and how he speaks practically to you, you can begin to partner up and team up with what God wants to do within your daily life, and also how he wants to guide you into the blessing of God that he has set aside especially for you. God has a purpose, destiny, talents, abilities within you that he's already purposed for you and inside of you. And it's up to you to begin to partner with God to unlock what he's put inside of you and the amazing purpose he has for your life. Being led by the inward witness is almost like a kind of a kinetic or inner knowing type feeling. A lot of us, probably everyone, has heard of the gut feeling, the peace, lack of peace. Everybody has a laundry list of things that they've not had a good gut feeling about, and then you ended up doing them anyway, and it got you in a wreck. I have a laundry list of those things myself. You also have a list of things that you know that you felt like God put that in your heart, or you had peace about doing it. You had this inner gut feeling and this inner knowing of, yeah, that's a good idea. And you did it, and you saw positive consequences come in your life. So whether you know it or not, that was actually, most likely, it was actually God's Spirit speaking to you and guiding you as your internal compass and your internal navigation system. So what this session is designed to do is help you become more aware of that, crystallize what that looks like for you, so your heart can become very sensitive to the nudges and the promptings, and also when God's like, hey, back up, pull back, don't do that type of thing. Or if he's like, hey, yes, this is good, more of this, or go this way, or make that decision, or yes, that what you're saying is in line with what I want for your life or the persons you're speaking over their life. So becoming more intentional about connecting with God's Spirit within you and keeping your heart tender and sensitive to the slightest nudge of the Holy Spirit will actually allow you to hear God's voice, active voice, on a daily moment-by-moment basis, because we've covered that one of the ways he speaks is kinetically. And this is a huge thing in people's lives. Literally, if you will develop this with God and allow God to tenderize your heart to the nudgings of the Holy Spirit, if you just did that in your daily life, Think of all the things that you didn't have a gut feeling about in the past that led to negative consequences that you knew you shouldn't have done. Imagine all those reversed in a positive direction and now those things didn't happen. You can literally be led. The Bible says you can be led forth by your peace, meaning the inward witness of the Holy Spirit within you. So if you don't feel good about it in your spirit, if you don't feel good about it in your gut, they see that the people often see this as like the center mass of your spirit, the center mass of your being. So it says out of the belly, Jesus said, out of the belly will flow rivers of living water, talking about the Holy Spirit. So it makes sense why we have that gut feeling, because Jesus said that's where the Holy Spirit would flow rivers out of there. So becoming more aware of what you're internally sensing is going to make you a more effective follower of the Holy Spirit, and you're going to be able to follow His prompting and His nudging, and then you'll be able to say, okay, God, why don't I have peace about this? What are you saying about this? And then you listen actively, and maybe God will give you a picture, or you'll see what you should be doing, or you'll see a decision that God is prompting you to make, or you'll get a flow of thoughts that He'll explain to you why you have a peace about a certain decision, or why you have a lack of peace. Or it'll just be, you'll have such a strong feeling of peace about it, you'll know, okay, this is a go. I'm praying about this decision, but I feel peace about it. There's so many times my wife will ask me, hey, do you want to do this? You want to do that? And it'll be practical things within our life and raising our daughter and things like that. And I necessarily won't have an inner visual experience or a flow of thoughts, but I'll have an overwhelming feeling of peace, like God is saying, yes, go forward with that decision. Or I always have like a slight feeling of peace, and it's like God saying, yes, proceed, but proceed with caution and just make sure that you're listening to me throughout the process of this decision so I can course correct you if needed. Or if I have I don't have peace about it, I'll say, you know, hon, I don't have peace about that right now. So let's just continue to pray about it and let's just see what God does. But let's hold off on this decision, or let's not do this decision because I don't feel a feeling of peace about it. Let me go to God and see if I can get some clarity on why I don't feel peace about this person, this business decision, the way that we're raising our daughter, or a decision we're making and to put her in a certain class, or whatever the case may be. This is real practical, real world stuff. I am led by my inward witness in the peace of God, or the lack of peace that I have, on an everyday basis. If I say something, and there's sometimes I'll say something, and you know what? I don't feel, there's something almost like an itching in my stomach or my chest, and I'll have like this almost like a little anxiousness, and I'll say, you know what? That wasn't God's best for what I said or what I did or how I was thinking. And then I'll say, okay, God, why don't I have a peace about this? Why do I have like a check in my spirit? Meaning for me, I have an uneasiness in my spirit. And oftentimes He'll quote me a Bible scripture, He'll show me a parable, or He'll say something to me that will course correct in a loving, fatherly way of how I'm thinking, speaking, or something that I'm doing, or a decision that I'm thinking about making. On the other hand, I may ask God about a situation and then He gives me peace about it. And then I'll say, okay, God, how do you want me to shape this, to make this decision? Do you have any specific things you want to give me right now? And sometimes I just get the flowing thought, follow me and I'll show you. Meaning as you follow God, God's going to show you step by step relationally how to make that decision and how to go forth being led by your peace and the active voice of God. Also, when I'm talking to somebody and I'll say something, or I'll do something, or I'll make a decision and I have like a peace about it, God is saying, yes, more of decisions like this. Like, I'm approving of the decision you're making. I'm approving of this conversation. And it basically kind of crystallizes where, you know what? I have a feeling of peace about that. That might be a behavior, a thinking pattern, a decision that I want to make like that in the future. For instance, a lot of people, when they leave church, a lot of them feel uplifted. They feel like something got lifted off them. They feel like a peace, or listen to a spiritual song and it touches their heart. And they feel a feeling of peace, or like a lifting off. That's God or the Holy Spirit in you saying, yes, that's good. More of that. And He's approving of this spiritual food that you're intaking. That's just an example, but it can be a super practical example as well of making any kind of life decision. I want to encourage you, no matter how subtle these nudges are, as you begin to note them mentally and even journal down what you're sensing, or just even take a mental note of throughout the day how you're feeling internally. Do I have a peace about what I'm saying, what I'm doing? Do I have a lack of peace? What's going on in my heart? What's going on in my spirit? Is something in my heart or my spirit, let's say, is something in my spirit, and then something in my mind, my will, and emotions, is something not lining up, or is there a disconnect there that God wants to address or course correct with love? And so just becoming internally aware, an internal awareness of God within you, and these nudges, no matter how abrupt or how powerful or how subtle they are, there's so many times I've missed what God was doing because I had a subtle nudge to make a decision this way or say something to someone, an encouraging word, and then self-doubt came in. Oh, I don't think that was God. And there's so many times and it worked out and it really was God. God really was prompting me. That person was having a bad day, and really the word that God gave me to just encourage him with, it would have helped build them. Or I'll say, you know what? I feel like I should make this decision. There's like a thought in the back of my mind and a peace about it. That can't be God. I'll just dismiss it. That still happens to me even today. And then circumstances will play out and I'll realize what I was sensing and what I felt like I was hearing, even though it's very, very subtle, it was the Holy Spirit. There's times this is simple as practical stuff. Oh, I feel like I need to check my bag because I forgot something. No, I got it. And I felt like an uneasy, I got it. I'm sure I packed it. And then you get in the car later and you realize you didn't pack it. Like, that was as subtle as it is. God's in the everyday. He's in the subtle, man. He's in the practical. So the thing about it is being internally aware and beginning to intentionally press in to this internal awareness. Let's give you some practical ways you may experience the inward witness of the Holy Spirit. It may be a sense of peace or a sense of ease. It may be a sense of a yes in your heart. You feel, yes, I should do this. Yes, this is a good direction to go. Yes, this is a good decision to make. Yes, this is a good way of thinking. You have a yes. I call it a yes in your spirit. Internally, you may feel good about the decisions you're making. Again, learning what a yes in your heart looks like, learning what a sense of peace about a decision looks like, kinetically for you personally. It's like I can tell you all day long how good an In-N-Out burger is, but unless you've tasted and seen one, you just don't know. So a lot of this is experiential-based knowledge where when you intentionally begin to connect with the Holy Spirit in you and you're led by the inward witness, you'll know what a yes in your heart feels like. You'll know what a no in your heart feels like. You'll begin to sense these subtle and maybe not so subtle nudges and directings of the inward witness of the Holy Spirit. You may pray about something and feel good about it. And there's so many times that I'll feel kind of good about a decision and God again will be, he'll tell me, Sterling, be watchful or be prayerful. Meaning to me, I have this kind of download and he said that to me numerous times. So I kind of know what that means. Kind of a relationship when somebody says something to you or your parents say something to you. And there's a lot of history behind it. So all they have to do is say this one phrase and you kind of got what they're saying. Same thing with God. I've built history with God. You're building relational currency, relational history with God. So when he says things to you, like when he says, follow me, I know he's saying, in this case, if I had a yes in my heart and it wasn't a overwhelming yes, and I was like, okay, I do feel good about this. I feel like there's a yes in my spirit, the sense of, yes, go ahead and make this decision. And then I ask God, okay, God, what are you saying about this? And he says, follow me. Or he says, be watchful. I know that that means as I go through this decision-making process that I need to be watchful and prayerful about what he wants to do and how he wants to guide me. In contrast, an uneasiness or a lack of peace could be God saying to you, nah, don't make that decision. We've all had that in our guts, right? Don't do that. We talked about the laundry list that we all have, right? So again, I call this a check in your spirit. You feel like there's something off, and it doesn't have to be, some of us have those overwhelming gut feelings. We're like, no, it's a big no. And sometimes you're just like, I don't know about that. Again, check in with God when you're becoming, even right now, you're becoming internally aware of how he speaks through the inward witness of the Holy Spirit. And as you begin to intentionally check in with how you're feeling and discerning internally, through that process of repetition, through that process of relationally connecting with God, you'll begin to know what those feelings are saying, and God will give you an inner knowing and an inner download of what to do. But you have to relationally and intentionally connect, and your internal awareness is something you have to practice. I practice internal awareness on a daily basis. As I go throughout my day, I'm often checking in with my spirit, meaning I'm often checking in with the Holy Spirit. How do I feel about this decision? How do I feel about how today's going? How do I feel about the conversation that I just had? And I'm constantly asking God questions, and I'm constantly checking internally how I feel about that. Well, I felt good about that conversation. I felt that was what God was giving me for that person, or I should service my client like this. Or though sometimes in the business world that I'll make a decision and then I'll get an uneasiness in my heart. And morally and ethically, it's the right decision, but God calls us up higher. And I say, okay, God, why am I not feeling peace about that? And God will remind me, his integrity looks different. Yeah, you could do that and it's legal and moral, but it's not my best for you. I want you to pay this person more than you negotiated because that's the right price for that particular service. So you just have to learn practically and relationally what that looks like between you and God. You can also have like an anxiety or like a vibration internally that you have, and it's almost like your spirit is like an alarm clock or a smoke alarm that it's saying, no, something's wrong, don't do that. Or it's saying that, hey, there's something going on internally with you. You need to bring that to me. God's saying, you need to bring that to me so I can heal it, so I can release it. Maybe it's unforgiveness. Maybe it's resentment. Maybe it's worry or stress that you need to release over to him through prayer and just put it at the feet of Jesus. It can be a lot of different things that God is practically bringing to your heart so you can be a more effective person. You also may have like an inner conviction about something that you're sensing you need to bring to God that kind of goes in line with this. There's sometimes I have that inner conviction of, you know what? I wasn't being Jesus in the situation. I know there was a time, I love this story. I'm going to tell myself a little bit. I was talking to God, and it's me and my wife first got married, and I'm like, God, I'm right on this. And I was just telling him, I was right on it, but I had an inner conviction about how right I was. And that, hear the Holy Spirit say, is clear as a bell in my heart. I get the flowing thought. He said, yeah, you're right. But did you act righteously towards her? Meaning the way that you were right, did you let you being right supersede you treating her like Jesus and an extension of my love? And I was like, oh man, I gotta go apologize. So I went and apologized to my wife and told her that I was sorry for the way that I acted, and I didn't explain to her that, you know, I was right about the situation right then. Although later I did tell her what the Holy Spirit said to me, and she said, you know, honey, you were right, but you and I just, we handled it wrong. So that's a practical way of how that inner conviction can work in your life. One of the most important things you can do in being internally aware and in keeping your heart soft and pliable to the Holy Spirit is living a lifestyle of forgiveness. And you may say, Sterling, what does forgiveness have to do? You've been talking about peace and inner witness and being led by the Holy Spirit. What does forgiveness have to do with that? Well, when you're holding on forgiveness, it can be a blocker of things in your heart that you can internally discern. Meaning if there's a lot of unforgiveness or there's any a little bit of unforgiveness, like we talked about the pebble in your shoe, how irritating is a pebble in your shoe? And God looks at unforgiveness with resentment, frustration, irritation. It's all the same thing to him. Fear, stress, worry, anxiety, all those things can be unforgiveness for yourself, God, and others. And the more pliable, sensitive, and soft your heart is toward the nudging and the unction of the Holy Spirit, the more accurately and the more readily you're going to be able to be led by that peace or lack of peace. So this is going to keep your heart clean. Living as a forgiver keeps your heart clean to receive the flow of God's voice and the flow of the inward witness in your moment-by-moment life. So a key to being a spiritually successful person is living as a forgiver. And so what we're going to do in a second is I'm going to lead you through what's going to be called a forgiveness exchange. And I want to encourage you that forgiveness lives a lifestyle. It creates purity. It creates peace. It creates joy within you. It allows you to release people, you to release God, you to release yourself from bondage, and it gives you the power back where it needs to be. Because forgiveness only hurts the person holding it. Like unforgiveness only hurts the person holding it. It doesn't hurt the person you're holding it towards. So oftentimes, we're holding unforgiveness for ourselves because who can beat ourselves up better than us? Can I get an amen? I mean, I wish it wasn't that way, but that's the way it is. And then so many people hold unforgiveness towards God. If you've ever said to yourself, I don't know why God did that, or I wouldn't have done it that way, or why doesn't God bless me, or why is God doing that? That is subtle irritation, frustration with what you think God should be doing. And then with other people, I mean, you can scroll through your social media feed and get envious of another person. I'm like, God, I see you blessing them, but I know them. They shouldn't be getting blessed like that. And just to let you know, social media is an edited form of life. So don't take it so personal. No one is immune to the fire of life. So nobody has a perfect life. Nobody has it easy. That one I threw in for free. So no charge. Through my experience of coaching countless people, unforgiveness and unworthiness, which is like unforgiveness for yourself, has been the biggest blocker of God's voice flow in somebody's heart being sensitive and pliable and movable by the Holy Spirit. So living a life as a forgiver is going to allow you access to hear God effectively, correctly, and consistently. So the activation question, I call this a forgiveness exchange. So you're allowing the Holy Spirit to bring things to your heart that you need to release over to God. So in a second, I want you to ask the Holy Spirit to bring to your mind and your heart who you need to forgive, and then forgive them and notice what you sense with your inner self as you release these things over to God. Journal down your experience. I want to give you an example. You say, God, bring to my heart who I need to forgive. And then the Holy Spirit might show you a picture of yourself. And then you might see a scene of something that you did or you said against yourself. And then it could look like, God, I release that mindset, that way of thinking, what I did, I release that over to you, God, and I receive your forgiveness in Jesus' name. Holy Spirit, come and cleanse my heart, God, and give me peace and joy and comfort, Lord, instead of self-condemnation in Jesus' name. Amen. Super simple. It could be about forgiving God. God may bring a scene to your mind where you're envious another person that we talked about earlier, and he may give you a scene of you were telling yourself, you just said in your heart, I don't know why God's blessing them. He should bless me like that. That's subtle frustration with God and you not really understanding what God may be doing in their life and what he may not be doing. You don't know what a person has going on behind the scenes of their life. So in that respect, you'd need to forgive that person you held envy and jealousy towards, and also God, that you're frustrated with how you view God blessing that person. So So it would look like, God, I just release that unforgiveness for that person over to you, Jesus. I forgive you, God, for the mindset and the frustration, irritation that I had against you. And I release that over to you, God, in Jesus' name. Holy Spirit, cleanse my heart of unforgiveness, God. I thank you for the blessings that you have for me. I thank you for that you continue to pour out your blessings on that person, God. And I just worship you and thank you, God, that I live as a forgiver in Jesus' name. Amen. Super simple. But live this as a daily and weekly lifestyle. I would say this is something you should consider vital to your spiritual health plan, your spiritual fitness plan. I would suggest you do this at least 2 to 3 times a week where you sit with God, could be in your quiet alone time or any time during the day, and say, Holy Spirit, bring my heart who I need to forgive. And I'm telling you, it is amazing, especially after you get to do this as a lifestyle. It's amazing how God will bring things to your heart that may have happened 5 or 10, 15 years ago that you think are totally insignificant. But the Holy Spirit knows you better than you know yourself. There's times that I've coached people, they're like, hey, Sterling, I'll put them on a 3-week plan where they have to do this 2 to 3 times a day as one of the coaching exercises I do with them. And I would suggest you do the same thing. And there's so many times people say, man, there's so much stuff after the first week. God's bringing all this stuff up from my childhood that I had forgotten about, that he wanted me to release over to him. But then he showed me how that the way that what happened to me in that situation was affecting my thinking and limiting my life now. So what happened then was limiting my life now. I didn't even know it until the Holy Spirit brought it to my heart. So I'm telling you, living a lifestyle as a forgiver and living this as a lifestyle, and allowing the unction of the Holy Spirit to be so sensitive in your life is such an effective and powerful way to live and to hear and to move and know God's voice and know his activity. And God will lead you into his best for your life. So again, I just want to encourage you to not discount what God brings to your heart. And don't argue with God. Don't say, I've already dealt with that, Jesus. God may bring the same thing to your heart in a different way 2 or 3 times over a period. And you may say, well, I already forgave that person. Well, God may be showing you a different way or a different layer that he wants to release from you out of your heart and heal something in you. So I just want to encourage you to be led by the Holy Spirit. Keep your heart sensitive. Focus on being internally aware of what you have going on within you and let the Holy Spirit speak to you as you ask him questions about what you're sensing. And also, living a lifestyle as a forgiver can help you keep your heart tender, pliable, and movable by God so he can lead you into his best for your life. I know this has been a blessing to you. This has been a lifestyle for me. This has been an amazing, continual way that God speaks to me in the everyday. So I'll see you in the next session. We love you. And remember, Jesus loves you, and he wants to speak to you more than you want to listen.